Thermal energy moves around us all the time. You might walk outside, you might feel the rays of the sun hitting you. That's one way that energy moves around. You might put your hand on something that's a little bit too hot and get burned by it. That's another way thermal energy moves around. Or you might jump into a lake and notice that some parts of the lake, like below the surface of the water, are nice and cool, and the surface is kind of warm. And so, you know, why does that happen? How does thermal energy move around? Well, that's what this video is all about. How does thermal energy move? First off, thermal energy only moves one direction, and that is from hot to cold. It's very important that you note that thermal energy only goes from hot to cold. And that comes down to where heat comes from. I mean, heat, when we're talking about temperature and thermal energy, the reason things have thermal energy is because the particles are moving really quickly. So imagine a bunch of vibrating particles that have lots of energy. They're bouncing all over the place. And then imagine some cold particles that aren't really moving very much at all. They're just kind of vibrating slowly in place. If you put those hot particles, the ones that are bouncing all over the place, next to the ones that are kind of slow and cold and not moving very much, I mean, are the cold ones ever going to give energy to the hot ones? No, I mean, that just wouldn't make sense. The high energy particles are the ones that are going to transfer energy to the cold ones. And that's what always happens. It's just the natural flow of energy is always from hot to cold, or from high energy to more low energy. And so when you look at these pictures here, this glass of ice water, you might think that the ice is actually cooling down the water. Well, it is, all right, duh, it's cooling it down. But what's really happening scientifically is that the water, the energy from the water is going into the ice cubes, and that's what causes them to melt. It's not the ice cubes like transferring their coldness to anything. It's really the ice cubes are sort of sucking the thermal energy out of the water. That's why it gets colder. And the same thing happens outside. Found this cute picture of a baby all bundled up. We bundle up in the winter so that we can keep our thermal energy, so that it doesn't get sucked out by the cold. See, the high energy particles in our body are bouncing all over the place, and the cold are kind of moving slow, and they end up like absorbing energy from our body. So we want to keep our thermal energy, and that's why we wear all this fuzzy stuff, is to keep that thermal energy inside. The first type of thermal energy transfer we'll talk about is conduction. Conduction is the transfer of thermal energy between particles of matter that are touching. It's the transfer of thermal energy between particles of matter that are touching. Things have to touch in order for conduction to happen. So if you were to reach into an oven and grab a cookie sheet, if it was too hot, that would be conduction. You'd be like burning yourself because the energy from the cookie sheet would be going into your hand. Same thing with a frying pan. If you reach in and grab a frying pan, if it's a metal handle, it might be kind of hot, but if it's a plastic handle, it might not be so hot, because here's the deal. Another thing with conduction is that certain materials conduct thermal energy really well, and other materials don't. So metals are excellent conductors of thermal energy. If you have a cast iron fry pan at home and you put it on the burner, it won't take long for that handle to heat up because the thermal energy transfers through the pan and into the handle. But if it's a plastic handle, it's going to travel up through the pan, it's going to hit the plastic, and it doesn't travel well through plastic. It goes like really, really slow and just doesn't go through very well. And so that's why a lot of fry pans and tea kettles have plastic handles. It's kind of handy. A couple other examples of conduction in action might be a hot iron, ironing clothes, picking up a cup of hot cocoa and feeling the warmth of that hot cocoa by touching it, by touching the cup, and then a camp stove, the camp stove heating a pot, and then the pot in turn transferring the energy into beans or something that you're cooking up, and then going out in the snow or holding an ice cube, you know, the thermal energy from your feet going into the snow. But the thing you have to remember is that conduction is all about direct contact of particles, particles touching. Our next example of thermal energy transfer is convection. Convection is the transfer of thermal energy by particles moving through a fluid. It's thermal energy transfer by particles moving through a fluid. And that fluid can be gas or liquid. I used to think that fluids were only liquids, but fluid can be gas or liquid. And so I have a question for you. When you look at this pot of boiling water, how is it that this whole pot of water actually gets to a boil when only the flame from the burner touches the very bottom of it? How does that happen? How does the whole thing start boiling? Well, the reason it starts boiling is because of convection. Convection allows the water to circulate. It creates these convection currents that heat up the entire pot. So when you heat up the water that gets heated ends up rising, And then the cold water replaces it, and it creates a convection current. And we see convection currents happening all around the world, in the air, the atmosphere, underneath the Earth's crust, and in the oceans. It's anywhere there's a fluid, there's probably going to be a convection current. And so when we take a look at the winds, for example, the air at the equator is much warmer than the air in the poles. And so when those two things mix, when hot air mixes with cold air, you end up getting hurricanes, you end up getting tornadoes, you get wind, you get weather, and we feel that all the time. It's because of convection currents. Hot rise, cold sink. Hot things rising, cold things sinking. The same thing happens theoretically underneath the Earth's crust. We have, you know, magma, and the magma is hotter in some places than others. It's very hot near the center of the Earth where there's a lot of pressure and a lot of heat. And as it heats, it rises, and when it gets closer to the Earth's crust, it cools off and it sinks, and there it creates this current, and that current is what drives our continents to move just a little bit each year. We haven't been able to, you know, drill down that far to really know this 100% sure, but nonetheless, it's a theory of how things work, convection currents underneath the crust. And our last example is this big chunk of concrete in the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. This chunk of concrete is a dock from Japan that's now in the United States, and it didn't come by boat. It actually came by ocean currents. In 2011, there was an awful earthquake. It was a 9.0 magnitude earthquake in Japan, and it created a tsunami. And if you know anything about tsunamis, when the waves pound the shore and they come in, they end up actually sucking a lot of debris out into the ocean. And that's exactly what happened in Japan. A lot of debris was sucked out into the ocean. It took a year and a half to get across the ocean, but ocean currents actually ended up carrying that debris over to the United States. Not all of it, but a good deal of debris ended up showing up on the West Coast about a year and a half later, including this big chunk of concrete. So it was all about convection and convection currents. Our third and final method of energy transfer is through radiation. Radiation is the transfer of thermal energy by waves that can travel through air or across space. Radiation is the transfer of thermal energy by waves that can travel through air or across space. And so when you go outside and you feel the radiation from the sun hitting your face, that's radiation. You feel the same thing from a wood fire. If you feel the warmth from the fire, that's radiation waves coming out of the fire and hitting you. And so you're not touching the fire. It's not conduction like touching. It's not fluid like a pot, sort of like flowing water through a pot. It's you feeling these electromagnetic waves flying through the air and hitting you. The same thing happens in other objects too. It's not just fire. It's not just the sun. It's also everything that actually has any thermal energy, you know, in it. Because all the time what happens is that other forms of radiation like gamma rays and UV rays and visible light hit objects, and then the objects absorb the energy from those waves, and then they end up emitting it as infrared radiation. We can see that with infrared cameras. And so if you've ever seen Cops, like the show Cops, or you played some sort of video game where you had night vision goggles, those are cameras that actually can see infrared radiation. And so what that might look like is in this picture, where we've got a picture of a house, and you can see an infrared image of the house. It's very small, but you can see the door right here, and you can see the window right here. And you can actually tell from this picture which areas of the house are hotter than the other areas. And so this yellowish area is actually warmer than the cool blue area. And this, you know, bright yellow area right here, that might actually tell us that that part of the house, or this part right here, is not very well insulated, or maybe this window isn't closed all the way, or there's a crack in the bottom of it where some of the heat is escaping. And that's really helpful because, you know, people want to save on their energy bills. They don't want heat escaping during the winter. They want their houses to stay warm. And so that's radiation. That's the last one. That's it for the video. We studied conduction, which was the thermal energy transfer through the direct contact of particles. We talked about convection, which was the thermal energy transfer through the flow of thermal energy through fluid. It's all about flow and convection currents. And then the last way was radiation, which was the transfer of energy through electromagnetic waves. That's it. Hope you like it. Take care.